The stock markets introduced internet trading or online trading in February 2002, which has brought a tremendous change in the industry. It was in 2002 when National Stock Exchange started the first form of online trading, wherein users or investors could buy and sell stocks in a day without much paperwork. Earlier, it used to take around 60 days to buy or sell stocks in the stock markets, and the investors also had to go through loads of paperwork. In India, online stock trading has grown in popularity during the previous 2 years. During the pandemic, millions of Indians took up stock trading, sparking optimism that the thirst for equities in the world's second most populated country is finally expanding. This session will discuss the rise of trading platforms in India and how these trading platforms will change the future of stock trading in India, while also the effect this can have on the economy and the markets. Moderating this panel today is Ms. Shruti Trivedi, Partner Strategy and Transactions with EY, who is joined by Mr. Varun Sridhar, Chief Executive Officer of Paytm Money, and Mr. Sandeep Bharadwaj, Chief Executive Officer, Retail of IIFL Securities. Over to the panel.
Good afternoon, everyone. It's actually great to have an in-person discussion after such a long time, in-person panel. So thank you so much and welcome our panelists.
Thank you.
Most important thing which we are going to discuss here is the interesting concept of change in trading through mobile apps, which has actually created so much traction in the last 2 years. So what we have seen is over the last 2 years, numbers suggest that 60 to 100% of mobile clientele on mobile apps have increased. NSE from April to May has increased contribution from mobile trading to 23%, which has been the highest ever. So in this time, it is important to discuss how you people who are the key players in the market, how you are taking it up as a, lapping it up as a good opportunity, how you are looking at the sustainability and, how it is going to create more market for everybody. So my question to you first, Mr. Bharadwaj, would be, how do you think this change in mobile trading has changed the patterns of investment among investors?
Yeah. Good afternoon. Thank you. It's a very interesting question. But here, we need to see two terms associated with it. One is trading. Second is mobile. So both has evolved in India differently. Now we mix it up and see together. But when you look at mobile, how it has evolved in the last 2 decades, mobile itself is a evolution. Today, 90% of the Indians carry a mobile instrument. Second thing we need to look at is internet. How internet, which used to be privileged things in past, has become a common asset. Today, every household in India has access of internet, the person who uses mobile. Third thing, the cost of internet. If you look at the India as a country, internet cost is the cheapest. So you precisely pay 6 rupees per GB kind of cost. So that makes infrastructure readily available for every person. So you have a mobile, you have an internet. Not only that, internet cost, you also look at it today, the cost of mobile. I remember 2010, the mobile cost was, average cost was 20,000. Today you get a smartphone as low as 7,000, 6,000. In fact, if you go, you will get a smartphone in 3,000, 4,000 also. So what does it suggest? That every Indian today has an access of smartphone.
Correct.
With the accessibility of internet.
Yes.
Now that empowers you. Now let's come to investment. You know, India has a various waves, where it was a debt wave, then it is a gold wave, then it came to real estate wave. Now, at this point in time, India is riding on equity wave. Now, when you look at equity, what has made this equity wave accessible? Today, when you look at FD interest rates, when you look at small saving interest rates, and when you look at inflation. So if you put your money in these instruments and you benchmark it against inflation, your money is eroding.
Correct.
You keep it in a bank account, your money is eroding.
Correct.
So where to invest? So the entire ecosystem from investing point of view suggests you to get into equities. if you look at last 20 years of equity returns, it has given a 14% CAGR return. And Indian equity market has still not grown up. Today, 4% to be precise, is a demat penetration in India. It means not every Indian is investing in equity. Though it sounds so big, we are talking about equity wave, we are talking about so many demat accounts getting opened. But to be precise, 4% people are today investing in equities. So when you look at, put together these two things together, that empowers you. You have infrastructure, you have a place to invest, and put together, that becomes a right opportunity for customers to get into.
Right. So that is interesting. As you said, 4% are only investing in equities. So going forward, how do you all plan? And I would like to ask you, how do you plan to create more awareness among your investors to come on this, and it should not just remain a hype and it becomes a sustainable business and more and more consumers are onboarded? What kind of awareness you guys are going to, you are looking, will be created in the market?
Should I go?
Yes.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. I think what you just said is fantastic, because the wave is here, right? And we were just talking about it. I think equity has now become a vada pav conversation, a thali conversation, a dosa conversation, a dining table conversation, a time when people can sit with each other. Earlier we used to talk about movies. I think Bollywood has come down, and maybe Stockwood has gone up, right? I don't know if there's a word like that. But I think that's the biggest change, right? It's become a common man conversation, and that's the single best thing that could happen, right? What also is happening is all of a sudden there's this new India, young India, which wants financial independence. And I think what happened to us in 1947 was we wanted independence of mind, of body, of governance. I think this decade, 2020 to 2030, is about asking for financial independence. So the need has come, the hunger is there. Now, as players, right, as platform players, we're essentially wealth managers, right? What we do is make it simple for you to manage your money better so that you can work less and your money can work harder, right? That's our job. And if you're able to do it at a good price, at a good, reliable, secure, safe way, it's good. But I think the biggest gap there is education, right? Between people actually wanting to dream. Like, I think if there's a product in the world which said, aap ye paisa, you put it here, and I will give you, 12%, 14%, whatever, X return, and you don't have to do anything, everybody would be there. The truth is, that doesn't happen, right? That's a mirage. So people are therefore trying to manage their own money. The gap between desire and reality is knowledge. Now, how does that knowledge get spread? I think there are three ways it gets spread. First is actually to teach. But, I think in India, people like to drive first before they get their driving license, right? I think they like to cook first before going to a cooking class. They'll paint first and then go to a class. And I think that's what is happening. As people experience the market, and, sometimes when the market goes down, we get a lot of consumers saying, hey, you know what, I've lost 1%, 2%, 3%. What am I supposed to do, right? And I think that's when the need comes that I have to get educated. So I think there's a need to say, I want to get educated. Then people like us need to give that platform, right? You can't expect people to come back to a class, right? For example, at Paytm Money, we're doing a lot of master classes. These are digital live sessions, okay, where people from anywhere across India can log in. We did a session on women-only investing. We did a session on ETF-only investing. We had option traders, so we did a basic session. All these are digital live events which are hosted. We give tickets. Thousands of people come, they go when they want, they see when they want, right? So that's one way we do it. Second way I think you do it is while the product, which is in our case a mobile app, teaches you along the way. Like, that's the best learning. As you trade, can you give them some information saying, don't do this, don't do that, right? As you think about that, I think that's the second pillar. That can the product, which is the mobile app, can technology start giving you bits and pieces of information? Like, if I tell somebody, I will make you do a PhD or a master's or a BCom in stock investing, nobody's going to do it.
Correct.
Because it's 3 years and your instant reaction is correct, right? Nobody's going to do it, including me, right? But the truth is, that needs to happen. So if I can break those 3 years in bits and pieces of 10 minutes each over the next five, I think it's fantastic. And the last thing I think most important is to talk the language that the users want. Indians don't talk in English all the time. Like, hum log kitni Hindi mein jyada baat karte hain, Tamil mein baat karte hain, Telugu mein baat karte hain. The truth is, all of finance is in English. And I think the real big jump from 4% to 40%, which is America or China, will only happen when we talk in the language the consumer understands. And I think that's when education will happen, right? So, that, these are the three principles we are working on at Paytm. We think that if we can get to, in our mutual fund business, we have one customer in 99% of all PIN codes in India. right? Which is a lot, right? Which makes us happy. So if we can do that in equity, it will be fantastic. Yeah.
That's interesting. So multi-language awareness is also something which you are looking at. That's interesting. As you mentioned that there are various products specifically for each of the consumers, how do you see different kind of products coming in market, or where do you see more traction will be over the period of time? Which kind of products are there where you anticipate more demand coming in over the period of time?
Say, if I take this question,
yes.
What we have to understand in equities, there are two broad-based concepts. One is trading, another is investing.
Right.
Normally, we get confused when we talk about equities, that in equities you lose money. Every person who comes into the equities lose money. But we need to look at and separate these two product streams, because these two itself is a different products. Now, when you choose to be a trader who require a trading, opportunities, then technology also plays a critical role. Historically, there are a lot of information were manually available where you have to go read. Today, the technology has bridged the gap. All those informations today, when you look at chart, you look at technical analysis, you request the micro level data that is readily available on a small screen.
Okay.
And that information helps you to take action, which is you place a trade. And that is much more informed decision. You know that with this technical indicators, which direction you are anticipating stock or Nifty or market to go. Basis that you trade. Historically, you used to call someone, you used to ask him kya lag raha hai, what to do,
okay.
And then you used to tell him to place the order. Now, what he's placing, what he's not placing. So that was a fear. That was the doubt. That entire doubt has gone. So a lot of products are available today in trading point of view. Industry is moving into open APIs, where companies are extending their APIs to individuals, where the customer or sub-brokers or organizations can consume those APIs and can build their own products as well. So it is not only organization providing products, even by extending the APIs, which as an organization, IIFL Securities have also the beautiful open API architecture, which we give it to our consumers, and they are making and innovating their own strategies and own product.
Okay.
That it comes to trading. When it comes to investing, what is the most important question to answer is what to buy. Historically, people used to ask, "Achha, kya lag raha hai? Kya khareedna chahiye? Koi tip de do." Now, gone are those days. When you used to ask such questions. Now, what you need is you require certain information. You have to assess your risk ability to take the risk. The artificial intelligence assess your risk, and basis the answers you provide, basis the filters which you require, makes you the ready-made portfolio. Now, it is good for you to just click a one button, invest in that portfolio, and have a peaceful night, because you have done an informed decision of investing. Now, this kind of opportunities makes you, one, investing in equity. Second thing is investing in equities with a better informed decision. So there's no later regret of making losses.
Right.
See, losses and profits are part of equity investing. But when you look at investing, investing is normally perceived to be 3 years plus business. When you invest for 3 years plus, there are very rare chance, unless until there is some unfortunate event, you lose money. As I was quoting, last 20 years, if you look at the equity, the equities offered 14% CAGR return.
Right.
Now, what you only understand is the basket of products, basket of companies, where to invest in. Now, this
right.
kind of technologies are simplifying that for a consumer. And our mobile app also, have various such products, curated products, where you can have thematic basis, your own filter basis, you can go and invest. So this trading and investing, these two are the classified, stream where, such products helps customers take decisions.
Can I maybe add to that question?
Yes, please.
I think the two statements I'll make. One is, I think next 10 years, 2020 to 2030, is the single best decade for wealth tech business, right? Like, I think this is the decade that India will see. I'm happy we are part of it, right?
Yes.
I think, future generations will maybe benefit from what people like us will do over the next 10 years. So fantastic decade. But what's changing from a product perspective? I think there are two big things that India is going to see. First is bonds. Right, I think the whole, like most Indians hold fixed deposits.
Right.
What they don't realize is behind the fixed deposit, the bank is actually holding a bond, and the bank is taking that money in current account and then giving it as a loan. So the difference, actually, technically speaking, the banks are making the profit. As consumer awareness goes and as interest rates come down, what's essentially going to happen is individuals are going to start buying bonds. And RBI and Mr. Modi and the SEBI and everybody else very recently started doing central government bonds.
Yes.
Right? And it's very, very new. But I think there is a definite push. And across the world, bonds is a very important part of every individual's portfolio.
Mm-hmm.
I think so next 10 years, I can almost bet that 20% of retail AUM will move into direct bonds held by individuals. So that's a big, big, I think, a wave coming to India and to Indians. And instead of holding FDs, which we all do, I think we will start slowly saying, instead of FD savings, let me hold central government bonds. Let me hold maybe Lucknow Municipal Corporation bonds, which Mr. Yogi was trying to promote, right?
Correct.
Maybe I want to hold a corporate bond.
Correct.
Right? And I think that's one category. Second category is ETF. I think the whole mutual fund industry, active fund industry will have to start thinking, what about the passive industry? And passive, you can either do through index funds or you can do through an ETF. And, you know, I'll give you a small number. December last year, we were one of the first people to actually do a masterclass, as we call it, on ETF.
Okay.
Right? And most of my team and most of the people said, Varun, nobody's going to turn up. I said, yaar, karo, dekhte hain, you know, in America, 40% ETF, Europe, in Indians will understand, right? And they said, yeah, you know, what should we communicate? I said, why don't you communicate as follows? If you invest in an ETF, you have the lowest expense ratio. Why would you do a mutual fund? Or why would you do direct stocks? I can tell you that today, we have unimaginable number of customers holding an ETF. Almost 20% plus have at least one ETF of the Paytm Money equity database, which is fantastic. The ones who hold ETF have seven ETFs, right? And if you look at the number of ETF launches that's happening in India, the second big product, I think, over the next 10 years is going to be ETFs. Because a lot of people are going to be into passive investing. The other word you will hear is passive.
Yeah.
That I don't have time. I don't know how these markets work. It's too complex. Can I just buy Nifty? And can I do an SIP in Nifty and be done with it? Can I do a SIP? I don't know. Because I like tech stocks, I want to do that. I like FANG, which is an American thing, which Mirai launched. I want to do that, I think. So the second big thing is going to be ETF. So bond and ETF on the product side. On the channel side, I think India is going to go from me telling you to us telling each other, which I think is the community. What's happened on social media, Facebook, Instagram, you know, you have the likes of 10 different platforms. I think that wave will hit the wealth management space in the next 10 years. So I think 10 years out, these are the three big changes I think that we should look for.
Okay. That's very interesting points which you both have made. One, that 2020 to 2030 is going to be a wealth tech scene. And also, of course, that the change is there in investing versus trading. What I would like to understand here is two major questions which emanate from that. That retail customers are becoming a major contributors here, millennials being the contributors, tier 2, tier 3 cities are becoming the contributors, and Indian customers are very emotional about their money. How do you give them that sense of security? Yes, it is technology, but it's stable, it is secure. So what is going to be both of you, how do you see that, what additional work will have to be done in this phase? Because this is going to be a critical age now.
So, I think this is very important. Risk management, when we look at risk, protecting risk is the key objective of any organization. And before organization, regulator also comes into the picture. And thankfully, in Indian context, the regulator playing a very critical role. They are simplifying things for as far as risk management is concerned. Today, when investor takes a decision to come into the equities, they need not to be worried about the way they used to be 20 years back or 10 years back or even as recent as 5 years back, because the risk management as a whole was so complex. Consumer was not known, not aware of that if I give my money to company to invest in, first of all, whom I am giving to my money with. What he's going to do, if I buy my share, where this share is going to come to, there are various, terminologies revolving around. So where my shares will come, when I'll get my shares in my account, and if I take another position, what will happen to my shares? So there used to be a various doubts in, consumer minds. Today, regulator has simplified those things, as also put all companies at the same page. So today, my company or the Varun companies or any X company, they can't play around the regulation. They need to offer the same risk management solution to consumer. So what happens on this platform when everybody's on equal side, what you can do, so you can work around providing the good products which gives consumer which gives customers opportunity to make more money. Now what happens when you look at say ETF or a mutual fund, we always look at average returns. So yes, mutual fund, the way I quote the 14% CAGR, or mutual fund when we look at the large cap has given, you know, last 5 years say 40% return, average 40% return. But when we always talk about 40%, everybody is not invested averagely. How this spread works like. So if you look at the top quartile has given 80% return. Medium quartile has given 40% return. But the bottom quartile in the same space has given 20% return. Now, if you as a consumer are part of bottom quartile, you will feel cheated that if mutual fund, large cap scheme has given a 40% return, why did I get a 20% return?
Yes.
Somebody, you know, my friend, say Varun has invested in a scheme which got 80% return. I invested in the same kind of scheme which gave me a 20% return. You don't feel like, you know, this is the it is the same page. You feel like cheated.
Yes.
Now, what happens when, as an organization, with the help of technology, we do a lot of backtesting. We provide all such information to consumer and make him more informed about the decisioning. So it's not emotion or bias-based decision. It is well thought of with a backtesting of data. With matching of your objective, you take the decision of investing, whether it's a mutual fund or ETF or equities. Else, in average out, a lot of people lose money as well. Average out, I can sound very positive about it, but millions of people have lost money also in equities in 20 years, you know. So what, as an organization, we are doing, we are providing such information to customers while before placing their orders in any of the stream in mutual funds or equities or, bonds, where customer are likely to make less, losses vis-a-vis, unless or until he chooses to, wrong instrument. Second thing is, regulator, when you look at mutual funds, so like all of us have seen the campaign like mutual funds are here.
Yes.
You know, the one thing is how you invite people to get into the products. I'm just extending my answer to the previous question,
yes,
which you asked also, that how the education also helps. So when you make the awareness amongst people,
mm-hmm,
where organization as well as regulator as well as a lot of startups have come who have their products available on the same mobile handset where you need not to go somewhere else, just click a button, you will have small videos, micro learning to a major learning. You can have 60 minutes video to 2 minutes video about the same subject and you have some understanding, and that understanding helps you to take some bit of decision or at least get into that this product is right for me. Once you define that this product is right for me, this further information is available which helps you within this product, what is right for me? What is my time frame? What is my risk, taking ability? Collectively, we help customers to take decision.
Correct.
Yeah. If I may add, I completely agree with him, and I'll maybe try and throw in a slightly different perspective. I think you made a statement, how do you make consumers feel safe? I think that's a wrong expectation to set to start off, right? Because I did skydiving once, right? My skydiving instructor before I went to skydive made me sign a declaration, if you die, it's not your fault, right? Now the truth is, I think there are different type of consumers, and you spoke about risk, which I think is the right thing. I think there are different type of risk appetite. As a platform, as an industry, what I love about SEBI is their whole sole mission is I have to protect the Indian consumer. Because you're correct, Indian consumers are extremely emotional, but everybody's emotional with their money. I am, right? You try and take 5 rupees from me away, which you did not promise me that you'll take away. You will have my best emotion out very quickly, right? And I think that's life, because we worked hard for it,
yes,
as a country, as a person. When you get money easy, you're not so emotional about it. But I think being emotional with hard-earned money is every person's right, right? So yes, you're correct saying they're emotional, but I think somewhere you have to decide what is the consumer's risk appetite. And we call it in our language client suitability, right? Now, in India, what I would tell people is don't trade, don't do futures and options if you find it difficult. Like, don't go skydiving if you feel, is there a chance that you may die? Yes, but I'm here, right? I did scuba diving, and when I did scuba diving, same thing, I got my instruction. But does that mean that I don't do it? No, but it means that somebody's informed me before of the risks. Somebody's tried to educate me a bit, right? I took a 6-hour lesson before I went on my flight. Did my tests. I think these are important things. So if I now flip that to equity, how does it work, right? So I think client suitability is important. You need to start educating clients, saying, hey, you know what? Cigarette smoking is injurious to health, right? That you need to be invested long term. Now, a lot of clients, at least what I like about the last 2 years, is a lot of clients have started to understand a bit more. I don't say everybody, because I really find there's a lot of FOMO happening. So more often than not, when somebody says, hey, Varun, what should I buy? I said, because you're asking that question, you should not buy. Right? I said, till you know and till you've invested, I said, hey, did you learn driving before you took your, you know, you went with the car? Yeah. I said, did you go into the beach first time in your life? No, you normally go to a shower, bathtub, swimming pool, beach, right? And I said, hey, if that's your process, you should not invest. Don't trade. When I say don't trade, I know that we will suffer with revenues, but I think we are here for the long run. We are here for the next 30 years. I would love that Indians save, invest, take their time. So I think a lot of what we do as platforms, as institutions, is to build up client suitability. And I think in India, what I like is the regulator started to think, saying, hey, are you suitable to do futures and options? Are you suitable to do ETF trading? Are you suitable to do intraday? Are you suitable to buy this IPO or not? Right? Are you suitable to, if your risk appetite is so small, then maybe a fixed deposit is for you. And if that's the case, it's perfectly fine. Right? But I think that's one whole client suitability. The second thing I think is a bit of what I would call teaching people about how to learn how to manage risk. Right? Like saying, okay, you have 100 rupees, don't put all 100 into a risky thing. 10 rupees is your asset allocation, 90 you put safe, try with 10. If 10 gets lost, you're not on, you know, you're not worried. Right, your life doesn't change. And I think that's going to be the second message. So yeah, so I would, you know, add to what you're saying client suitability and asset allocation. If you can teach people that you decide your risk limits, I will do a great job. And I always tell people, don't trade if it's tough, don't trade if you don't know. It's perfectly fine. We'll figure out our revenue models, but I wouldn't want any retail individual to lose his capital. Right.
What also you look at it, you know, absolutely, you know, Varun is absolutely precise in saying, but when we say trade word is very abused word, but trading itself is an objective of consumer.
Yes.
And investing is a different objective. Unfortunately, what happens when these two gets mixed? When you start using your investing money into trading. The trading objective is what? That today I define my objective that today I want to earn 500 rupees. End of the day. What is trading? Trading is I'm going to trade during the day. End of the day, I should make money. This is what this is trading is all about.
Right.
What is investing? I'm defining my goal, basis that I'm allocating my funds, defining the timeline. That within this timeline, I want to achieve this goal. And I'm choosing the right instrument, which can be equity, which can be mutual fund or ETF. And I invest. And then I forget. And I look at, review that, okay, after 3 years, I got my objective achieved. Right. Unfortunately, when I start going every day and see, my investment has made only 1% or 2%, let me rebalance it every day. So from investing, when you move into trading, consumers, normally fail to understand.
Right.
So as an institution, we also, we're trying to help consumer to make them aware that what kind of products we're getting into. This product is not a trading product. This product is a trading product. So today, option is investing.
Correct.
Option is largely trading. It can work as an investing, but then it has to be invested through a proper knowledge with a proper fund manager who takes a larger position for a long-term point of view. These are hedge funds. Those gives you spread.
Right.
But those returns can't you expect that I invest in a company and over the period of time I make money. So objective has to be very, very well
and
defined.
Your risk appetite has to be set.
So all these platforms, what beautifully are doing by leveraging capital, customer risk or client persona, are helping him to know where he can invest, what kind of fund he can allocate to different instruments to invest with, and what kind of returns he can expect.
Right. So all the activities which are happening, what kind of technology trends you foresee? Because I see that a lot of startups have jumped into the bandwagon. How do you see technology startups playing a role in this entire where the consumer market is increasing? We see tremendous increase. We see demography changing. So So how do you see that technology and new startups coming in? What is the role they are going to play here?
Can I go first?
I think
they're, you know, important topic on the technology side, if you may. And I'll give you two examples. We very recently launched something called Paytm Wealth Community. Right? Essentially, it's a live video community. Because we saw everybody is doing video. Everybody is going Insta Live, Facebook Live, TikTok. All of that was happening. YouTube, right? Netflix, Amazon. Everybody's moved to video. But the financial services world is not anywhere near video. So we launched something called Paytm Wealth Community. It was an idea from one of somebody who's less than 25 who came and said, Varun, you know, why are we not on video? And I was like, yeah, what do you mean? And so we draw out a product. We got it going. Today, we have thousands of people logging in all day long. And all of this runs free. Mm-hmm. Creators come in. They see live video. So you're talking. And they're seeing it live and they're answering and they're chatting with the creator. So the creator could be a stock investor, creator could be a trader, creator could talk in Hindi, Tamil, Gujarati. They're talking all languages and it's all, everybody's working with each other fully free. The big difference now is it's secure. When you hear somebody on YouTube or Twitter, you don't know who he or she is.
Yeah.
You don't know is he even credible, is he even, you know, front running you. So I think that's a good technology where I think live video delivered to millions of people allows all of a sudden, together with transaction capability, to really change the game. Because all of a sudden, you're talking about doing Netflix in the stocks business, right? Which doesn't exist. So that's one. Second thing I'll tell you is we've just launched, I think a week back, voice trading, right? And there what we're saying is essentially you can talk to your app, right? Like why do you need to sit in your app? So imagine, and the use case came again from a trader, right? And there was a trader who does options all day long, uses five screens, and he's got a mic, and he's running everything. And I was like, yeah, you know, what if you could talk to that mic? Right, because all of a sudden, you don't need to type anything anymore. Mm-hmm. You could talk to your computer. You could be driving at 9 o'clock in Bangalore traffic, right? And you could be stuck in, you know, maybe you're driving a Tesla or a Tata EV vehicle, and those EV vehicles are digitally technology so enabled. If you could talk to your stock market, all of a sudden, trading time is down. It's easier. Many people can talk in their language. So you're not necessarily stuck to understand terms. With time, what I see is you could be talking in Hindi. You could be talking in Tamil. I'll take it, translate it to what makes sense, and get the execution done. So I think on the technology side, and one thing you said, you know, about startups and bandwagon, I think it's India's most important bandwagon, if you may, because I think great capital markets is equal to great country. I love the startups which are coming in. I think the energy there is so fantastic. The young people in India, we have faith in them at Paytm. You know, Vijay always says, if India changes, it'll change because the startups will make India change. And I think we're very, very happy with that. So we are looking forward. I think next 10 years is going to be about these 10 crazy startups which changed how Indians manage wealth.
That's going to be really interesting.
Yeah, so just add to what Varun has beautifully explained. So what I see, that what is the role of a technology? The way we see a role of a regulator, the role of a technology is to make it easy for you. Make it habitual for you. So
yes.
Where it is helps you to do habit forming. If you remember when 10 years back, you used to go bank for every small things. Withdraw money, deposit money, checks. Now the technology has removed those things. Now you carry a bank in your hand. So it has created an ease. It has made you habitual of using that app or that device using for that purpose.
Correct.
So biggest role of a technology is to make it accessible, easily accessible. That is what technology also playing in the capital markets. Now, as we explained that entire capital markets you carry in your mobile, how technology for a retail consumer is helping that he for identifying, discover where, what to do, to execute, to track, and to evaluate. If you look at this entire process, it's a very complex process, and you require qualified people to execute this entire process. Technology helps retail customer at a click of a button to do this entire stuff.
Correct.
So where he is well informed about his decision, he can take right calls even after investing if you know his calls have gone wrong, because everything is available with him. And that helps him to, you know, so I see the technology going forward in 10 years. Product will evaluate, evolve, no doubt about it. You know, debt funds will come, ETFs will get mature. And that is a lot more to do with the Indian GDP, the Indian economy will evolve.
Right.
The product suitability will also depend a lot more on that. But what I foresee is that today this 4%, when we say 4 people out of 100 people invest in equities, but with the help of technology, I see 100 people out of 100 people in invest in equities. That is what is I see the role of a technology.
That is going to be a fantastic time for all of us. So with that, I think that has been an interesting panel discussion. I had so much more to ask, and I'm the lucky one to interact with them later on also. So thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.
It was fantastic. The understanding which you guys have and the future which you see, I believe in it. So thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Shuchi. Thank you to all our speakers as well. It has been a wonderful session for sure.
100 रुपये में बिटकॉइन ट्रेडिंग
पॉसिबल है?
इम्पॉसिबल
लगी सर, और हारा तो इट्स पॉसिबल ऑन कॉइन स्विच कुबेर. डाउनलोड करो और बिटकॉइन में ट्रेडिंग स्टार्ट. कॉइन स्विच कुबेर, सिक्का चमकेगा.
क्रिप्टो करेंसी इज अ नॉन रेगुलेटेड डिजिटल एसेट, नॉट अ लीगल टेंडर एंड सब्जेक्ट टू मार्केट रिस्क एंड प्राइस फ्लक्चुएशन रिस्क.
Where there is life, there is hope, there is meaning. But life has its downs, as much as its ups. Life is about challenges. Life is about opportunities. Time for joy, time for celebration, and time to introspect. Thankfully, in every one of life's moments, and even beyond life itself, there's LIC. Where there is life, there's always LIC. Zindagi ke saath bhi, zindagi ke baad bhi.